Dear student, your Miss Science Miss Kamrun Nahar is going to discuss about chapter 3, External Morphology of Plants. Okay, so we know that dear student, class 7, this is your science miss Kamrun Nahar. Today I am going to discuss about chapter 3, External Morphology of Plants. Now, modified adventitious roots. Adventitious roots are modified for performing special functions. We have earlier known that the main function of root is to entangle trees with soil. Roots may be modified for performing special functions. Now, modification of roots will be discussed, but for their modification, there are basically three reasons. One is storage of foods, mechanical support, physiological activities. Roots are modified for storage of food basically four types: tubercular roots, fasciculated roots, nodulous roots, moniliform roots. Now, they are described as modified for storage of food. Storage of roots such as carrots, beets, and sweet potatoes are examples of roots that are specially modified for storage of starch and water. So, we got the information about the storage type of tree. They store food as starch and water. Now, tubercular root. A tuberous root is an enlarged fleshy root modified as a storage organ with shoots produce at one end and roots produce at the other end. Dahlia sweet potato is produced from a tuberous root or tubercular root. So, we are getting the information about tubercular root. This is the figure. Now, I am again repeating the slide. A tuberous root or tubercular root is an enlarged fleshy root modified as a storage organ with shoots produced at one end and roots produced at the other end. Dahlia and sweet potato are produced from a tuberous or tubercular root. Now, tubercular root. A tuberous root or tubercular root is an enlarged fleshy root modified for storage of food. Achha. As a storage organ with shoots produced at one end and roots produced at the other end. Storage, this is the storage portion and this is the root. This is the total root. But this is tuberous form because here is the storage of starch and water. And here is the root. Now, fasciculated root. These are tuberous roots arising in cluster from the base of the stem. This is the stem and here is the roots are produced as a cluster. Okay. An example of this type of root is Dahlia asparagus. Now, nodulous roots. These are very common because we eat ginger. Ginger is an example of nodulous roots. These roots become swollen at their tips due to accumulation of food, as for example, ginger. These adventitious roots are swollen at frequent interval. Look at this figure. Frequent interval. Frequent interval, they are swollen. This gives the root a beaded appearance. Beaded means one after one swollen makes a necklace-like structure. This is called bidding appearance. Is it clear? One after another, there is swollen condition of roots. This is look like necklace, and this is known as a bidded appearance. Now, monilliform roots. Look at this form. Monilliform roots are fleshily adventitious roots which are swollen at regular interval like beads of a necklace. An example is bitter gourd. This is look also like necklace like beaded form and swollen also one after another regular interval. This is known as monilliform roots. Okay. Now look at the swollen position. One is swollen and other is not swollen. This is the alternative position or after regular interval. Okay. This is known as monilliform roots. Now I am going to the previous slide. So modified for storage of food, there are four types of roots: tubercular roots, fasciculated roots, nodulous roots, monilliform roots. Now we are getting the picture of these roots. This is tubercular roots. This is fasciculated roots. This is nodulous roots. Now this is monilliform roots. Now roots modified for mechanical support. There are three types of roots modified for mechanical support. Roots help the plants to stand straight, to climb, or to float in water. For this reason, adventitious roots are modified variously, such as prop roots, steel roots, and climbing roots, in some cases floating roots. We will discuss these three types of roots. Now, prop roots. Prop roots, these type of roots grow from the stem of the branches and come down and enter into the soil. Look at the position. They have grown from the branches and also they reach to the soil. Finally, they become so thick that it looks like a pillar, such as banyan. Okay, this is an example of prop roots. Here the roots is produced from the branches and reach to the soil and looks like pillar. An example of prop root is banyan. Now, stilt root. Few plants have weak stems and cannot stand erect. So, few roots develop from the lower part of the main stem and tangentially reach the ground and grow, such as stilt root of screw pine. Screw pine is the example of stilt root, and look at the characteristics of the root. Few plants cannot stand erect, and for this reason, few roots develop from the main stem and reach tangentially to the ground. And this is the characteristics of stilt root. So, prop root is produced from the branch and reaches to the soil. And stilt root produced from the stem tangentially and reaches to the soil. Now come to the third one, climbing root. Climbing root. These roots grow from the nodal region of weak stems and helps the plants to climb with another plant, such as battle vine. Okay, look at the position. They are just climbing the other roots or host, and from the nodal region of the weak stem and help the plants to climb with another plant such as battle vine. This is the example of climbing root. Betel pine is the example of climbing root, screw pine is the example of stiff root, and banyan is the example of prong root. So it is clear, it is just climb to other stem or nodal region of the plants, and this root is produced from the stem and this root is produced from the branches of the tree and reach to the soil. It also reach to the soil, it also produced other roots that helps to climb other trees, basically from the weak stem or nodal region of the weak stem. Now, modified adventitious roots, modified for performing physiological activities, aerial roots, parasitic roots or sucking roots, respiratory roots, reproductive roots. Okay, besides the normal function, adventitious roots are modified to perform special physiological functions. Aerial roots, this is the example of aerial roots, absorbs and store moisture from environment. Okay, this is the figure of orchid. Here the roots are produced to absorb and store moisture from the environment. Now, parasitic roots or sucking roots. Parasitic roots or sucking roots occur in parasite for absorbing nourishment from the plant. Hence, they are also called sucking roots. The parasitic plants sends posterior a special type of roots into the host. Example of parasitic roots is gold creeper, that is called Shornolata in Bengali. I am repeating it. Parasitic roots occur in parasitic for absorbing nourishment from the plants. This is the host plant and this is the parasitic plant. This parasitic plant send a special type of root inside the host. Okay, this special type of root is known as posterior root to the host, and they are getting or absorbing nourishment from this host plant. Example is gold creeper. This is the gold creeper and this is the host plant. Okay, now respiratory roots, or it is known as new metaphor. This is very important because it is found in the mangrove forest, basically in Sundarban. In this case, branches roots from the main root come from the saline and muddy soil in the coastal region. The basic characteristics of these roots is these roots are developed in the coastal region, basically in the mangrove forest. These roots have small pores on them, and these modified roots are called new metaphor. Okay, these are called new metaphor. This is mangrove forest. Sundari Goran are the example of plants which develop respiratory roots. New metaphor is here and it helps in breathing purpose. And in this case, the total situation occurred in coastal region where the water is sometimes saline. Is the basic characteristics of the soil is the salinity and muddy soil in coastal region, and this root is developed with small pores which helps in breathing of the plants. And these plants are basically developed in the mangrove forest that is found in our Sundarban. Example of respiratory roots which plants have Sundari and Goran. Now, reproductive roots. Some fleshy adventitious roots developed buds which can grow into a new plants. These are called reproductive roots. These roots serve as means of vegetative propagation, such as sweet potato, dahlia, etc. That means these roots can develop other plant. Okay, that is known as vegetative propagation, where no sexual reproduction is occurred. Only if you cut the root and just put it into the soil, it will develop another plant, small plant. That is the example of sweet potato and dahlia. So this is a root of our sweet potato, and you will see after leaving the sweet potato for few days, it will ultimately grow young plants. If you put that sweet potato into the soil, it will develop new plant. So I am repeating, some fleshy adventitious roots develop buds which can grow into new plants. These are called reproductive roots, and these roots serve as means of vegetative propagation. Only this type of roots helps in vegetative propagation, sweet potato and dahlia. So we are getting the information about modified for performing special physiological function roots. Now I am just closing this lecture. Okay. Thank you, everybody.